สวัสดีครับ and good afternoon once again. Today is Saturday, the 16th of January, 2021, and this is the English language summary of the daily press briefing here at the Center for COVID Situation Administration, or CCSA, as always. So starting first with the general situation and numbers that we have for today. At the moment in Thailand, as of today, we have active cases in Thailand numbering up to 2,704. That's a very good number because, as you notice, if you have noticed from yesterday, the active cases were higher than this, and then we have been treating and discharging. There have been many patients who have recovered already. So the active case in Thailand remains at 2,704, as you see on screen. For the daily numbers, we have 270 cases today, recorded for today, of which 83 cases are from local transmission, 126 cases from active case finding, and 21 cases from the state quarantine system. All in all, with the numbers from last year, it's over 11,680 cases cumulative in Thailand. The daily recovery number that we have is 618. Total recovered is around 76% of the total number of people who were infected with COVID in Thailand. That's 76% recovery rate. But in summary, 2,704 is the key number of active cases in Thailand at the moment. Unfortunately, we have one additional death, one additional fatality, making the cumulative number of deaths 70. The 70th death is a 67-year-old Thai male with existing medical conditions. Just some observations from the briefing of the spokesperson. He actually showed a lot of numbers and graphs and maps, which actually point to the trend of the various clusters, meaning the trend of downward trend from the gambling dens or from the Samut Sakhon shrimp factory and the rest. So just some updates on the weekly situation. The new wave since December had so far given rise to 7,400 plus cases, particularly for the new cluster. The number of cases dropped from 2,674 last week to 1,627 this week, which is a positive sign that the outbreak will soon be under control. And these are the numbers particularly for the cluster, the new wave that began in December until today. Most of the confirmed cases are found in the 10 provinces that have the numbers of cases over 50. So these 10 provinces have 50 cases and over. They are mostly in the central and the eastern part of the country, such as Samut Sakhon, Bangkok, Rayong, Chonburi, and the rest you can see on screen now. They account for more than 94% of all the cases total that we have. So the CCSA strongly encourages the residents of these 10 provinces you see on screen to strictly follow the disease control measures and to practice DMHTT. You would recall that already now. Distancing, wearing masks, hand washing, temperature checking, using the Taichana Mochana applications. And if the number of confirmed cases in these provinces reduces, the curve nationally will flatten significantly. The CCSA is also considering the method to increase active case findings. The Public Health and Labor Ministry are laying out the plan to conduct testing in the highly controlled area, especially among migrant workers, to reduce the number of asymptomatic infections, as well as to ensure that infected persons, regardless of their nationality, are actively treated with medical attention. Just some clarification on the work permit renewal. This is perhaps useful for the English language community, foreign businesses, employers, that for most of the foreign workers who are now currently residing in Thailand and wish to obtain the work permit renewal, the Department of Employment has confirmed that currently there is still no requirement to obtain the COVID-free COVID test certificate for work permit renewal. The test is now only necessary for workers from Myanmar, Laos, and Cambodia, while workers of other nationalities only need the usual medical certificate. However, the Labor Ministry has informed that they are currently in the process of including COVID-19 in the list of diseases that foreign workers must submit to certify that the applicant does not have any conditions. So the new regulation is expected to be effective next month. So please keep yourself updated on the issue. For migrant workers from neighboring countries, I wish to give a small update on the registration for legal employment. The employers can now submit names of employees on the e-permit website, which started yesterday. And currently, more than 16,000 plus workers have submitted their application through the system, which will be open until the 13th of February. So we'd like to ensure the public that all registration is done through online platform, which have been developed to prevent large gatherings in controlled areas. On one issue I'd like to highlight is the term vaccine diplomacy. Vaccine diplomacy. Since vaccines are of crucial importance now, that's the word of the day globally, I believe. It's important for us to find and procure and distribute vaccines in a timely manner for all countries at the moment. Many countries are finding effective vaccines and advancing vaccine diplomacy and discussions as a global public good, to make it a global public good that every group of people are equally gained to access. And since the pandemic began, the Ministry of Foreign Affairs has been implementing vaccine diplomacy to provide more opportunities for the Thai people to access vaccines by using networks from Thai embassies around the world, connecting Thai health agencies with international pharmaceutical companies and vaccine companies such as AstraZeneca and Sinovac Biotech, that the process is currently in progress right now. And moreover, the Thailand International Cooperation Agency, or TICA, has been continuously cooperating to provide assistance to neighboring countries on COVID. Key issues of cooperation include coordinating with provincial administration in terms of policies and planning, providing health and medical consultations between public health offices and sister hospitals with other countries in border areas around the country, and organizing online workshops and courses for medical personnel from neighboring countries and beyond to exchange knowledge. Collecting knowledge and data on COVID vaccines and sharing them online, and rendering support on medical equipment in accordance with urgent needs of our neighboring countries. So just in closing today, I'd like to thank all the businesses that have actively followed the disease control measures so far as announced by the CCSA. Their cooperation in fighting this outbreak is of utmost importance, and we all appreciate their efforts. The advice of best practice for businesses is very important. We should limit the number of people entering their facilities and cleaning measures, as you can see on screen now in English. Yes, and also today, of course, it's also Teachers' Day in Thailand. I'd like to wish to express gratitude to all teachers who have been actively giving classes through online platform, which increase the number of work that they already have to endure. So thank you very much for your attention today, and hope to see you again tomorrow. Thank you. Have a nice weekend. Sawasdee krap.